Hi there. Today I'm going to show you how to assemble and configure the DeskPi mini cube for Raspberry Pi 4 CM4. Okay. Here is the instruction of this product. And this one is the enclosure of the product. Okay, I have this assembled all of the things, and today, right now, I find a Raspberry Pi CM4 computer module, and I remove the copper pillar from the heatsink, and then I need to install this computer module to this micro cube. Just press board to board connector and make sure it contact secure, and then put the heatsink on top of the CM4 module and fix the copper pillar. Okay, that's it. But I don't want to put the top cover on this mini PC, and I have not installed the NVMe SSD driver yet. It need to be configuration after I booting up from TF card. Okay, and here is 32 gigabytes micro SD card, and I need to use card slot and put it to my computer and flash the latest image of Raspberry Pi OS. Code number is Bookworm. Okay. All right. Okay, I will open the application called Blender Etcher. Okay, and I need to select the file which I need to flash to the image. Bookworm 64 bit. Okay. And select the TF card, flash. Okay, it's done. And before you use the TF card, you need to modify the TF card. So just remove the TF card from your computer and reinsert the TF card to your computer. And and then you can navigate to the file manager. And open the folder, find the config.txt file here. At the bottom, adding this parameter dt over lay equal dwc2 comma dr underline mode equal host. This parameter is to enable your USB port. Enable USB port, okay? And save it. And close this file. Safety, remove the TF card. Okay. And remove the TF card. Insert TF card to your micro. Here. Card slot. Into card slot, okay? And then we need to booting up this operating system and modify some file, and then turn off this mini PC and install the NV RAM SSD driver. Okay. All right. Let's use HDMI cable. And power supply 5 volts 3A. Okay, all right. And I need to connect a mouse to USB port. And change the source on your screen and press the button to boot up. When the double click, when the finally is turned on and the white light is turned on, means the Mini Cooper is booting up. And I will remove the, turn the camera to the screen. All right. It's booting up. Okay. Okay, click next, and I will init my configuration. Alright, I'm in China, so I change the country to China, Shanghai, use English language and use US keyboard. And also I have a Bluetooth keyboard. I want to connect to my Bluetooth device. Okay, this is my keyboard and the pair. Connection successful, and then I will input my username as Pi and my password. Okay. After that, I will select the Wi-Fi network. Here is my network, and input the password of your network. All right. Next. And here I will skip the update software procedure. Due to I need to modify some configuration of my DNS resort and press restart. Okay, I will open a terminal and execute some command. I'm going to change my DNS configuration so that I can access the repository of Raspberry Pi OS, okay. Result, I will change this one to Google DNS, and my local DNS. Okay, and I will execute sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade. If you encounter this error, just wait for a few minutes because the cron table will running background. So, just wait for a few seconds, maybe. Okay, my connection is okay, and the kernel version of this operating system is 6.1, okay, and it's a 64-bit operating system. You can execute this one, but this command is not available for CM4. You can see that is not enabled by default on CM4, so you don't have to modify any EEPROM's data on your Raspberry Pi. Just update your repository. If this error is still here, you can just reboot your Raspberry Pi. Okay, open a terminal. Okay. Here I have already updated the repository and I need to upgrade software. It may take a while. And after doing that, you can just use this software. Which called SD card copier. You can use this copier, copy your operating system to your M.2 NVMe SSD. But before you're doing that, you need to install this NVMe SSD card to your mini PC, okay? So my plan is to install the NVMe SSD drive after upgrading all of the systems package, and then booting up the Raspberry Pi again. Okay, we need to wait a few minutes. It depends on your network status. Okay, some area will take a long time to upgrade the operating system. Just be patient. Almost. It's almost here. Let's check the temperature of your The temperature of the CPU is still at 33 degree. So the heat sink is efficiently, okay, on heat dissipation. So I like this mini PC very much. It's smaller and powerful and funny. Everything is up to date, so you need to execute this command, sudo smnc means synchronize the buffer to your TF card. Here you can see that right now I have used the MMC block 0 P1 and P2 because I have already used the TF card to booting up this device, okay? And then shut down the system and install the NVMe drive. Change to my device. All right. Keep the TF card insert into the slot, okay? And double click the power button. Okay, I have to open our terminal and you can see that there is a device called NVMe0 N1 which has 238.5 gigabytes. It's a disk, and it also has two partition. It means my mini PC has recognized the NVMe disk, and I will format this disk by using fdisk command. I will delete the partition, okay? And use part proby. Use a part proby. Okay. And here is my NVMe disk. It's empty. And I will use the this one, which called a SD card copier, and from my TF card, copy to device my NVMe SSD drive, okay? And in order to make sure the system is copied from the TF card, so I will put some file on the desktop. My image and I will put something here. My image is from my TF card. All right, I have put the text file on my desktop, okay? And then I will start a copier. But before I do that, I need to make sure this one, my boot/firmware/configured.txt file has this parameter, because I need to enable USB port. I need to enable my USB port by this command, this parameter, okay? And make sure this one has the same parameter. You can see that the latest version has changed the configuration file to here. All right. Okay. And press start. Sure. the copy complete. Press OK and escape closer. You can see that right now I have a boot from TF card. And I need to okay, everything is okay. And then I will shut down the system. Okay, and then I will remove the TF card. And press power button to turn on the device. You can see that it's booting up. And I have removed the TF card from here and booting from the NVMe disk. Okay, let's open a terminal. Let's open a terminal and check if it's booting from the NVMe, okay? That's it. So hope this video can help you to finish your project. Thank you. And bye-bye. If you have any question about this tutorial video, or you have some question, please let me know. Okay? Have a nice day.
And then